Page six now. In taking out Iran's top general Soleimani of their terrorist military arm, the man responsible for 603 American deaths and countless maiming of our soldiers, you'd think by the media response that we'd taken out Mother Teresa or some kind of hero of some kind. When are mass media networks going to get their Trump derangement syndrome under control? Sympathizing with terrorists? Blaming Trump for conflicts that have been going on for over 40 years? I'd say it's official. These people despise Trump more than they do terrorists responsible for taking American lives. Joining me now, the founder of the American Truth Project, the Daily Ledger contributor, Barry Nussbaum. Barry, you have to be honest with me. When you heard this news last night, what'd you think?
I was very excited and gratified that President Trump, as the leader of the American Armed Forces, is taking up the position of Commander-in-Chief. Soleimani was the leader, not a joke, of the largest, most well-financed international terrorist group on planet Earth. And to have the attitude of these various talking heads that you just played is despicable. He's a mass murderer. He has made no secret of the fact that Iran wants to conquer that whole side of the world and eventually planet Earth. His death was long overdue, and the Democrats can't congratulate Trump for taking out a mass murderer. I'm disgusted, and it sends the world a message that we, at least the Democrats of the we, are wussies and need to be led by someone strong, and we need to unite behind him. And in this case, based on what happened yesterday, that would be President Trump's decision.
Worldwide response, the reaction by, for instance, Israel to this information and what happened with Soleimani, did they have a hand in this in any way, shape, or form?
Well, I have a couple of answers. First of all, the Israeli response internally is one of ecstatic sigh of relief. This is the guy, General Soleimani, that was very open about the fact that Iran has placed a large number of troops, missiles, and short-range and long-range missiles, I should add, and other equipment in Syria for the express purpose of destroying Israel. Now, whether or not they had a hand in this, we will probably never know, but I can tell you Mossad has agents on the ground in Iraq, and they are cooperating fully with the United States, and they are very gratified by the actions that were taken yesterday. They know, just as we know, and I say we in the military of the United States know, this guy was the worst enemy on planet Earth of the United States. So people that understand security issues, national security of the United States in particular, are very pleased today. And the people that say we shouldn't have done it or things will escalate are stone cold idiots. This guy has blood on his hands from all over the world and deserved to die a decade ago, not yesterday.
I wonder why it took them so long to take this man's life. Here is a man who's leading the state sponsor, the largest state sponsor of terrorism in the world. And he did it with a little help from $1.7 billion from the Obama administration and other things that we've done for him. What do you think about the juxtaposition of what he's done to our troops and the state sponsor of terror in other lands, not just against the United States citizens, and the fact that this guy's dead now?
I couldn't be more pleased. He's been brought to justice. One of the senators, a Democratic senator in the United States, said he should have been brought to trial as if we had the ability to extradite him. These types of people should be found and killed whenever possible and always for what they have done. I can tell you the days of the United States kissing the tushy of Iran with billions of dollars and the Iran nuclear deal are over. Thank goodness. The Iran nuclear deal did nothing but embolden Iran. We gave them billions and billions and billions of dollars, which they made no secret about. They have spent on exporting terror all over the world.
One quick thing.
Stop developing long-range missiles.
Let me ask you this one thing. The White House greeted one of the persons who was leading the assault on the U.S. Embassy in Iraq, and that was during the Obama administration. What do you say about that particular meeting? I know you have to meet with bad actors when you're president of the United States, but good God.
I read the news and I was disgusted. To bring a terror leader into the White House and greet him as some sort of political equal worthy of the respect of the office of the presidency of the United States is beneath contempt. And I'm really sad to say it is not the only bad actor Obama welcomed into the Oval Office. And yet, today, it's getting virtually no press. This guy is one of the leaders of the attack on the U.S. Embassy in Baghdad, and he was greeted as a friend and an ally to be supported by Obama. Oh my gosh, how's the world changed in just a couple of years by changing the person that sits behind that desk in the Oval Office?
Elections matter.
Somebody who says, you're a bad guy, you don't come to the White House. Mm-hmm. What a difference, eh?
Sure, yeah, you bet. Thanks, Barry, appreciate it.